So let's talk about HID sources and how they work. HID, high intensity discharge. We'll start with high pressure sodium and then talk about these four lamps, quartz metal halide. And then talk about these two sources, which are ceramic discharge metal halide. Now, there is another HID source, mercury vapor, but that's really going away. And there is a cousin to the HID group called low pressure sodium, which by definition is not a high intensity discharge source, but it's in the family because you'll find it in the same types of luminaires as the HID sources. So how does it create light? Well, you might liken it to a mosh pit or slam dancing. Yes, it is high speed collisions at high temperature, at high pressure. Why don't we light one up and see how it works? This is a quartz probe start metal halide lamp. You can see the salts flowing back and forth. They're sodium and scandium, and the two little balls are mercury in a liquid state. Let's take some time now and light this lamp up and see what happens when we apply current to the lamp. Like all guest discharge lamps, we need a starting aid. This is the UV enhancer. It puts a cloud of electrons into the arc tube to aid starting. Now let's ignite the salts and start the lamp. Now you see that blue emission line, that is the arc stream. The two hot spots at either end are the two primary electrodes. We've gotten the salts to energize. That little flash there is the continuing salt vaporization process. So just like a gas discharge lamp requires a starting aid, it also requires a ballast. Here we see a core and coil magnetic ballast, the iron core, the copper coil. In addition, there's a capacitor. This helps convert the volts and amps into watts more efficiently. And then there is an igniter because this is a pulse start system and it needs that igniter to start the lamp. HID lamps come in a wide range of sizes. Here we have a 20 watt ceramic discharge metal halide lamp that operates on an electronic ballast. And here we have a 1000 watt quartz metal halide lamp on a magnetic ballast. And these come in a variety of CRIs. This is a 21 CRI high pressure sodium. Quartz are 65 CRI. Ceramic discharge metal halide, 90 CRI. Color temperatures, 2100 Kelvin, 3 and 4000 Kelvin, and 3 and 4000 Kelvin. Where do we use this? In high bay or big box retail applications, outdoor, extreme temperature situations, and any place where you need a lot of light from a small package. Its benefits are durability, wide range of temperatures, high bay applications, dirty environments, and with CDM, energy efficiency. Its drawbacks, it takes some time to warm up, to restrike after going out. It does not dim very well. The CRIs are not very good except for ceramic metal halide. And the color temperatures are limited to really 3 and 4K.